It's 2020, yet somehow it still feels like our world was built with only men in mind. You can see it in the wage gap, in voice recognition software, and definitely in the fact that The Impractical Jokers got a movie. I sent Amy Hoggart to investigate how we got here.
The year is 1996. A female firefighter dies in a flame over. Fast forward to 2019. The first attempt at an all-female spacewalk is scrapped for, quote, safety concerns. Finally, in 2020, Amy Hoggart nearly dies while trying to reach her secret stash of dark chocolate. To the untrained eye, these and thousands of other deaths and injuries are unconnected incidents. But Caroline Criado Perez, author of Invisible Women, says the evidence all points to one culprit.
It's someone that I call Reference Man.
To me, Reference Man sounds like that dude Brian in The Office who just quotes Anchorman all the time.
Well, actually, Reference Man comes from the fact that wherever you look, you will see the male body being used as this kind of unisex, universal template for humanity. So, for example, an average male car crash test dummy.
Okay, so Reference Man is actually a big f***ing dummy, but he's just as cunning and deadly as other serial killers. What's his preferred murder weapon? Those little tags that say, one size fits all.
Reference Man is generally Caucasian. He's about 5'9", around 155 pounds, and he's about 25 to 35 years old.
I'm pretty sure I matched with him on Bumble. Does he like skiing?
The problem is there is not an average female car crash test dummy. She does not exist. Instead, we have a car crash test dummy that is about the size of a 12-year-old child. And in fact, when she is used in the passenger seat.
No way.
And the end result being that women are 47% more likely to be seriously injured if they're in a car crash and 17% more likely to die than a man in the same car crash.
Wow.
Basically, if you aren't a white man, you're going to have more problems.
Yes, anyone that doesn't fit Reference Man's mold faces a range of threatening situations, from the potential to be exposed to cancer-causing chemicals, to the dreaded 68-degree workplace. And this master of disguise seems to take on a different alias wherever he goes. This is Dr. Arga Van Sales, who used her 2 weeks of vacation and travelled across the country to volunteer in an ICU in one of New York's hardest-hit hospitals during the peak of coronavirus, while in return for these acts of selflessness, she was given the PPE equivalent of baggy sweatpants.
How am I going to do my job and do the right thing for the patient and for myself when stuff doesn't fit and stuff doesn't work for me? For a petite person, whether it's a man or woman or any other gender, that can be difficult to work with.
Meanwhile, the CDC only anticipated one problem with PPE size, so they created a guide for every type of white man's facial hair in Brooklyn.
When we're looking at Reference Man and using that as the gold standard for how we deliver care, as we look at racial ethnic differences between individuals, it does indeed affect the quality of care that we're able to provide to patients.
In some metrics, studies have shown that people of color can receive almost 60% worse care.
We have quite a few patients of Latinx or Hispanic descent, et cetera. And if we don't have a large subset of the population included in this thought process of this Reference Man, then we're failing our society.
If we really want to stop Reference Man, we have to go to the source of the issue.
The way that we eliminate Reference Man is for us to increase the diversity with regards to gender, with regards to race, ethnicity, to really get some different voices lending to conversations that lead to major changes within organizations. More women, more people of color, in conversations that are at a level that actually influences power, that you will begin to see systematic change.
That's right. If we're gonna stop this racist, sexist puppet, we're gonna have to stop the racist, sexist puppet masters.